Gervonta Davis was gonna fight Maris, but due to injury of Maris, now he's fighting Ruiz.
Yeah.
Now, if Tank fights Maris one day, what do you think of that fight?
Abner's a friend of mine, and a lot of people say he's like my brother because we always look like, and we look like a lot. So, I like Abner. I think Abner's had some wars in his career. We have a very similar career, me and Abner. We fought the best out there, win or lose, but we've given it a try. We've given it our best. We won world titles and we want to fight the best. But I feel that with Abner's style, he would cause Davis a lot of problems because Gervonta Davis, you know, he's going to stand there, he's going to wait. And Abner is a good fighter who throws a lot of punches, throws good combinations, has power and good movement as well. So, and he's not scared to get stuck into a fight. So, you know, he's a typical Mexican style. He's got likes to get involved. And so I like that fight for Abner Maris. I think it's a very good fight for Abner Maris. And also another thing about Abner is that fights like this will only make him like hyped up and get ready, you know, because he knows that he's going to be in a dangerous fight, so he's going to make sure he's on his A game.
Gervonta and Lomachenko, is that a good fight to you?
Lomachenko is probably one of the best fighters in the world. Pound for pound, I think. Very skillful. And I think against any fighter he faces, he makes it look so easy. He hits hard. He punches well. His timing is awesome. He's just overall a very good boxer and fighter. So he's one guy that I think most guys should stay away from, really, because he's very unorthodox, he's very awkward, and he's a very, very clever boxer.
Now, you said if you put him against anybody, he makes it look easy.
He makes it look easy.
Now, if they put him against Mikey Garcia, would it be easy for him this time?
See, Mike is a good fighter. At that weight. I think it's a very good fight, but Mikey, and that is a hard fight to call because they're both very skillful. Mikey has a little bit more power, I think, going into that fight. But that would be a very good fight. That is like a 50-50 fight because they're both very good technical fighters. And Mikey knows how to break a guy down. Mikey always finds a way. And Lomachenko always knows how to change his ways in a fight and how to, if he's not getting his way, he knows how to change. So that's a very good fight, man. I mean, it's hard to call that fight because I've never really ever thought about that fight ever happening because obviously the both guys are always going up and down weight divisions. But if that fight ever happened between Lomachenko and Mikey, I think Mikey might take it. But it just depends which Mikey turns up. And that's why, and it depends as well now, Mikey, would he ever want to go back down to that weight? And Mike now is fighting Spence, I think maybe after that fight he'd be like, I don't want to go back down to lower weight divisions. I don't want to fight the likes of Lomachenko and them guys because they're not really big enough names for him that will motivate him to cut all that weight down. So yeah, it's hard to say.